So well, I have this thing. I have this fetish. It's called younger men. Hey, you scared? You should be. Guy who knows who he is, is not for me. No thanks. I like a real fixer-upper of a human. You young man. Oh, just a real DIY project. I like molding you. Oh, you're so stupid. And impressionable. It's beautiful, you know? It's great. You know, I never used to relate to the song PYT by Michael Jackson, but now that is my anthem. You know that song? It's like, I want to love you, PYT, pretty young thing. You know the next verse. It's like, you need some fitted sheets. You do. All right, young guys, let's talk about your sleeping situation, young men. Can we talk about your bare serial killer mattress in the floor? Just disgusting, like, couch pillow for, like, your real pillow. Shower curtain for a comforter. Just an overturned cardboard box for your nightstand. No. I don't get it. You had a mother. What happened? What happened? Boy, let me buy you a duvet. Just let me into your life, boy. I'm gonna take you to Bed Bath & Beyond. Just gonna get you a dust ruffle, son. Ugh. That is my true medium, is cleaning up dirty young guys. That is my favorite. I've rescued a few from Austin. I have. It was fun, you know? I got a real dirty one, and I cleaned him up, brought him back to New York with me for a bit, cut his hair, helped him work on his resume. He started to resent me. What? And, you know, and I knew it because he was peeing on the furniture. And, I know. Had to take him back to the pound. I was like, you're going back to Austin. Sorry. Sorry, dude. But I love that feeling of, you know, being a woman with a career, like paying for my young unemployed boyfriend. Oh, that gets me high. It's a real great feeling. And it's so cute. My young unemployed boyfriend always tries to like pick up the check, but he does that like chick move where he's like not fast enough. Like the check goes down to the table. He's like, like, it's like, oh, I missed. Like his wrists are weak. Like, oh, I didn't get it. You know, you're like, oh, that's all right. You can get it next time. Okay, you know, but I don't want him to feel bad. I'm like, do you want to take my credit card up to the waitress? Do you want to pretend it was you? Feel like a big boy? Go ahead, live a little. It's a really fun power dynamic. See, I don't like to be on the other end of the equation. I've never wanted to be the young girl dating the old money bags dude. Because I feel like you always have to be like, can I have that? Just use like a tiny voice, like, please, I want things. Like, it's just, that doesn't work for me, you know? And you know what, young ladies, those of you who go to the club and you have no money and you're like, I'm gonna wear a tight dress and pretend to sleep with guys so that I'll get free drinks. No, that's a shitty business plan. I know all you are smart enough and you know it, but okay, if you're that person or you know that girl, if you don't have money and you want to go to the club and you want to get some drinks, you do what the rest of us feminist bad bitches do. You lean in, okay, and you steal an unattended drink, okay? And just when they're not looking, you're like, dead soldier, I'll take it. Like, glug, 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 you know, drink a cigarette butt. But who has their dignity? You do, bitch. That's my feminist message. Sleight of hand, little theft. Theft-ridden feminism, that's kind of what I do.